The bilateral squat is a fundamental movement in which we will use to train the lower body. Here I am pulling into the deepest range of motion of my squat with my ankles, knees, hips, while keeping the spine extended, and then pressing out, pushing the floor away as I ascend back up. We can progressively load by using a plate or a medicine ball within a goblet squat, but also using the plate or medicine ball to press out to help counterbalance and keep the torso upright. From there, we can use free weights within kettlebell or a dumbbell to use a goblet squat. And often at times, athletes have mobility restrictions within their ankle, knee, and hip region that elevating the heels is a strategy in which we can use. As you can see here, I'm using a dumbbell goblet squat with the heels elevated so that I can have a nice upright squat, minimizing any joint wear and tear. Another fundamental lower body exercise we will choose in our programming is a hip hinge. Here I am using more of a good morning version of a hip hinge, or I am holding the plate in front of me, driving my hips back through hip flexion and extending the hips as I ascend back up. Good mornings can also be with use of a barbell on your back if you're competent to hold the barbell. Our next progression and traditionally trained hip hinge variation might be more of a Romanian deadlift, as it's commonly called in classic strength training. Whereas here you can see I am holding the kettlebell between my knees, hinging my hips back. Two kettlebells or two dumbbells could also be used, as you will see momentarily, through our hip hinge. Here I am taking two dumbbells, again driving the hips back through hip flexion, coming up nice and tall through hip extension, being very careful not to overly bend through the knees or ankles, as this is again a hip dominant activity, whereas our squat would be training more of the hips, knees, and ankles. From there, we can progress with the use of a barbell, where we are traditionally training the Romanian deadlift, as it's often called. In our program, we will simply call it a hip hinge with whichever use of equipment that we are using. From here, you can progressively load through the barbell, weighing 45 pounds, to adding weight, making sure that we have good quality in our hip hinge and that there is no pain present.